population size and subproblem selection in MoEAD. I'm going to start with an introduction to explain the general context of this paper. Then I will explain why we review the MoEAD algorithm by dissociating the population size and the number of subproblems selected at each generation. Next, I will present you my experimental study and the results before to conclude this presentation. So, we are in a context of multi-objective and combinatorial optimization. In multi-objective optimization, we can't give one unique solution at the end of an algorithm because we have conflicting objectives. For example, between these two solutions, we can't give the best solution because the red solution is better on F1 and the blue solution is better on F2. But we can say that the red solution is better than the yellow solution because this solution is better on F1 and on F2. So the yellow solution is called a dominated solution, and if a solution is never dominated by another solution, this solution is called non-dominated, like the red solution, for example. So instead to give one unique solution, the goal is to give a set of solutions non-dominated. This set of solutions is called the Pareto set in the decision space, and it is called the Pareto front in the objective space. So the goal is to find a good approximation of this Pareto front, and because we are in this paper in a context of combinatorial optimization, all variables of our solution are discrete. There is a category of algorithm called evolutionary algorithm that manages a set of solutions during its process. So this category seems to be perfect to find a good approximation of the Pareto set. There are three steps in evolutionary algorithm. These steps make it possible to evolve the population to approach the optimal Pareto set. So at first, there is the parent selection. So parents will generate a new offspring by using genetic operators. Next, we replace this offspring in the population before to restart this process with the new population during a predefined number of generations. In our paper, we use a framework based on evolutionary algorithm. It is MoEAD for multi-objective evolutionary algorithm by decomposition. MoEAD wants to decompose a multi-objective problem into a set of single objective subproblems to optimize each subproblem cooperatively. The main component of this framework is the decomposition. The multi-objective problem is decomposed by using a set of weight vectors that represent subproblems. So we allocate one solution of the population to each subproblem. And solutions are then evaluated by using the aggregation function and the weight vector linked to the solution. The two main aggregation functions are the weighted sum and the Chebyshev functions, and we decide here to choose Chebyshev. One generation is done when all subproblems were visited. The second component of this framework is the cooperation. So each subproblem are solved in cooperation by using a neighborhood system. Each solution has a neighborhood composed by the nearest solutions. This neighborhood is used by the selection and replacement process of the evolutionary algorithm. So in the selection process, parents are selected in the neighborhood of a current subproblem visited. For example, here we select two random parents. This parent can generate a new solution, here in red. And next, for a replacement process, the offspring can replace only solution in the neighborhood. Even if the offspring dominates solution outside this neighborhood, because it's allowed to keep a good diversity in our population. And this process is repeated for each subproblem. One of the main parameters in MOAD is the population size. This parameter is very important because it impacts different components of MOAD. This parameter represents by definition the number of solutions in the population. It is the same definition as the population size in evolutionary algorithm. But in MOAD, this parameter impacts another component because each solution of a population are linked to one subproblem. This parameter also represents the number of subproblems available in the algorithm. And as we visit all the subproblems at each generation, it also represents the number of subproblems visited at each generation. This parameter is often tuned according to the knowledge from evolutionary algorithm. For example, a low population can be sufficient to approach the Pareto front in a reduced number of generations, but a larger population is slower but preferable to better cover all the Pareto front. And if the population is too large, it is a waste of resources because at a certain point, it is useless to increase the population. It's just going to slow down the algorithm. For some time now, a new component has appeared in MOAD. It is the resource allocation strategy. We know that subproblems in MOAD might have different degrees of difficulty, so the progress over some subproblems can be unequal. So in MOAD G-Array, for example, they have a system to allocate dynamically computation resources for more complicated subproblems. They used an utility function to compute the utility of each subproblem. Then each 50 generation, they execute a tournament selection based on the utility function to choose a sample of subproblems of size 1/5 of the population. So instead of visiting each subproblem during one generation, the algorithm will visit the sample of subproblem. So in our paper, we review the design of the MOAD framework to dissociate the population size of MOAD in three new components. The first, mu, is the number of solutions in the population, so it is the classic definition of the population size in evolutionary algorithm. The second, lambda, is the number of solutions selected at each generation. So, instead of visiting all subproblems during one generation, we will visit a sample of solutions. And the last, SPS, is the strategy of selection of these lambda subproblems, and we study in this paper three strategies. The first is the classic strategy of MOAD, so we visit all subproblems. The second strategy is the strategy from MOAD G-Array. So we used a priority function to prioritize each subproblem before to execute a tournament selection to choose the lambda subproblems. And the last is random, so we choose our lambda subproblems randomly. We use in our experimentation the benchmark multi-objective NK. It is a combinatorial problem with a representation in bit strings. There are few parameters to manage the difficulty of the problem. The first is the problem size. We choose a problem size of 100. The second parameter is K. It is the number of epistatic interactions to manage the rudeness of the problem. So we choose four values. And when we increase this value, we increase the number of local optima. And the last parameter is the number of objectives in the problem. So we choose four values. We choose the hypervolume as performance indicator, and more specifically, the hypervolume relative deviation. It is just to normalize the hypervolume. And the hypervolume represents the area between the Pareto front and a reference point. We execute each experiment 10 times and we study our components and our algorithm for a number of evaluations between 1 and 10 million. The first parameter to study is the population size. So, on this figure, we want to minimize the hypervolume relative deviation. Each column represents a different K of a benchmark, and each row represents the parameter M, so the number of objectives. Each color represents a different value of the parameter mu. So, on this figure, we can see two things. The first is with a small budget, so around here, a small population seems equal or better than a larger population. And with a larger budget, here, we have to choose a larger population to have a more detailed Pareto front. And it is the same observation as for evolutionary algorithm, like I explained at the beginning. The second parameter is the number of subproblems selected at each generation. On this figure, we want to minimize the hypervolume relative deviation in function of the parameter lambda. The column 1 and the column 2 represent two different instances of the problem, and the row 1 and 2 represent two different strategies. The first row is the strategy random, and the second is the strategy D-array. Each color represents a different budget. All algorithms of these figures are run with a population of 500 solutions. So, at the end of each figure, here, all subproblems are selected. At first, we can see that the best value of lambda, so we minimize this value. So for each instances of the problem and for these two strategies, the best value of lambda is never the highest value for a budget lesser than 1 million evaluations. So we must not choose all subproblems at each generation, except if we have a large budget for specific instances, for example, here. So, the observation for the random strategy, we can see that the best value seems different for each problem and depends on the budget. For the strategy of MOLD D-array, the original value of lambda is 1/5 of the population size. So here it is 100. And we can see it is not the optimal value. The optimal value for each instances seems to be 1. The last study is the SPS strategy. On this figure, we want to minimize the hypervolume relative deviation in function of the number of evaluations. Each figure represents a different instance of the problem, and each color represents a different strategy. We can see two things. The first is the better anytime behavior of a random strategy represented by the purple line here. This strategy is really better to approach quickly the Pareto front. And we can see this observation for all instances of this problem. But at the end, when we have a very high budget, it means when we are very close to the optimal Pareto front, the random strategy is not the best. So, in this table, we can see the hypervolume for one instance of the problem, but you can see all values for all instances in the paper. The hypervolume is given for different budgets, so we can see at the end of the algorithm, so here, the random strategy is not the best. The GRS strategy is better. So we can conclude that the random strategy is better to approach quickly the optimal Pareto front, and the GRS strategy is better to discover a detailed Pareto front at the end of the process. To conclude, in this paper, we review the design principle of the MoEAD framework by providing a more precise reformulation of the population size and of the number of solutions selected in MoEAD. We analyze the role of three design components, so the number of solutions in the population mu, the number of subproblems selected at each generation lambda, and the strategy SPS to select these lambda subproblems. We are able to derive the parameter setting recommendation of this parameter according to the properties of the problem. So here we study the weakness and the number of objectives of the MNK problem. The perspective would be to extend the analysis to a continuous domain and study the parameter setting online or offline of these three new components. Thank you, and if you want to contact me, you can contact me by email. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, and also thanks to Luis for stepping in with the video here. Okay, we have time for questions, obviously, because we started late with the video. Are there any questions? Okay, maybe let me start. I have a question about so there's two strategies you discussed where the random one was better for the anytime behavior and the other strategy was better towards the end. Have you thought about a hybridization and how you could you possibly switch between the strategies to get the best out of cards?
Yeah, it is the idea. The idea to continue is maybe to try with the random strategy to approach quickly the Pareto front. And at the end, when we are very close, the idea is to explore more with a more intelligent strategy like a GRA, for example, to find a more detailed Pareto front.
Okay, that's future work then.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Right, there are some questions in the chat. Can you see those? So the first one by Dan, could you explain slide 36? Please. Okay.
I'm going to check the slide. So it's the slide with the SPS strategy. So on this slide, we compare the different strategy SPS. So the strategy from MoEAD GRA. Oh yeah, I maybe can share. Share my screen. Yeah. So we can see that the best strategy because we want to minimize the upper volume. The best strategy is random, so we can approach quickly the Python front, and we can see on these figures, but we can see on the next table that at the end of the algorithm, when we are very close to the Python front, the optimal strategy is not random.
Yes. Okay. And the budget you said, so that would be the number of evaluations. And yeah. What is M and K over the top of the graphs?
The K is the parameter of a problem. So it is the number of epistatic interaction in the solution. So when we increase the K, we increase the difficulty of the problem, of the instance, by increasing the number of local optima.
Oh, it was a ruggedness. And M is population size then, or dimensionality?
I'm sorry, I don't understand.
And M, parameter M?
Is the number of objectives.
The number of objectives. And the number of evaluations is what you call the budget, right?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, there is another question from Huima. Why not use IGD to evaluate?
We use the hypervolume because I have not the optimal Pareto front to compare my results so for the moment. So I prefer to use the hypervolume. It might be not the best idea, but it's sufficient to compare our results here.
Okay. Are there any other questions? If you want to ask a question via the voice functionality, you can do that as well. Okay, this does not seem to be the case. Then thank you very much, Geoffrey, again.
Thank you.
And there is no actual applause, so, but still, thank you.